Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate certain cases while creating validation rule. So first is when record is created and edited. So validation will work in both the scenarios. Second, when record is created only, so we want our validation rule to run when record is created only. If it is edited, that validation rule should not work. And third is it's vice versa. So if a record is edited, then validation rule should fire. If record is created, then it should not fire, right? So before starting, if you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So I created a validation rule on opportunity. So this validation rule is, if an amount is not blank and description is blank, then this validation rule will fire and it will throw an error message that is please fill description, right? So right now it will work in both the scenarios while creating opportunity record or updating its record. So let me create new opportunity. So its name is test, close date, stage. So I filled all these details. Now I am filling the amount. So if amount is not blank and description is blank and I try to save it, sorry, this is not active right now, so that's why it won't work. So I'm activating this again. I'm creating new opportunity record. Filling the amount, but description is blank. Now if I try to save it, so you can see review the errors on this page. So it is showing please fill description, right? If we fill the description, then only this record will be saved. Now I am removing this amount and I am saving this. So it is created because amount was blank. Now if I try to edit this record by filling amount and I try to save it, so again this will throw an error message. So it is for description because amount is filled and description is blank. So this way it is working on both creation and updation. Now our second scenario is when record is created only. So it should work while we are creating new record. So we need to update this validation rule. And I'm going to add a simple condition here that is new. So this is added. So if record is new, amount is not blank and description is blank, then only it will fire, right? So I'm saving this record. Sorry, I'm saving this validation rule. Now I'm refreshing it. So you will see on updation, it will not fire. Amount will be filled and description will be blank. Still, we will be able to edit and save the record. So I'm filling the amount only, description is blank. So you can see this record is saved and you can see description is blank. So on updation, validation rule is not working. Now, if I try to create new opportunity record, and if I fill amount and leave description as blank, so you will see this is throwing an error message, please fill description, right? So this is covering the second scenario. It is firing on creation only. Now we need to revert it for editing only. So I'm editing this validation rule. And I'm just putting not with is new. So if record is not new, then this validation will fire. So on updation, it will fire. On record creation, it will not fire. So here, if I open this record, so here it is already. So let's try to create new record. So I'm filling name, close date, and stays only. I'm populating amount as well. Description is blank. Still, it will create this record. Right? Now, if I edit this record, amount is filled, but description is blank. And if I try to save this, so it will throw an error. Right? So this way you can use is new method whenever you want your validation rule to work for record creation or record modification. So accordingly, you can modify your validation rule. If you want your validation rule to work for both the cases, then you can remove this is new method. So this way we can implement all these scenarios while implementing validation rule. I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name, Sanjay Gupta, on YouTube, and you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.